Hey, how's it going, guys? Welcome back for another TOS video. Alright, so today finally Nihok is back. Free Mosasaur power release material, that's all I'm interested in. Alright, so ultimate stage, I'm going for the 3-star achievement team. Alright, so you can see here a leader different from ally, together with mono water as hidden condition as and a 5 member clear. Alright, so this is a 3-star clear. So I can't pass the chance to do a 3-star clear video. Alright, so I asked you guys on my page whether you want me to feature Lucy team or Yang Jian, the Pankara team. Alright, so don't worry, that's at the back of the video. So with this, let's go on with this mono water achievement first. Alright, so you can see first stage, pretty much just sweep everything. Battle 2, you got to target lock the 2 eggs at the side because they are not CD1. Alright, so after that, proceed to store on the front, the center. Right, because after it attacks, it will go back to CD5. So CD5 is a lot of time for you to store. Right, so store whatever you want to store. In fact, there isn't much to store because you get a CD reset right before the boss. So just use. So store whatever you need to go through for the back few stages. Right, so next battle we have these two dark, light and dark ethereal dragons. With revival, alright, they will revive each other, so this is too easy of a stage. Alright, so it's not gonna do much harm to us as long as you defeat one of them. They're just gonna revive each other, right? They're not gonna deal you any damage here. So in this case, you can see I just go for the convert because I'm lacking water runes to burst these two down. Alright, so you can see I'm actually conserving my water runes. Just using that one column of water runes there. Alright, so unfortunately my water rune just got like dissolved pretty much everything by the sky drop. Okay, so moving on, battle 4 is the core, the main stage. We have Agatha here with 90% HP reduction. Alright, so I went with a carry, Aquarius active skill. So for first turn I won't be dealing any damage. Right, basically I just want to store up the multiplier, and then with that I can actually build up more water runes on the board. Notice that I do not have water runes at the start of this battle once again. Right, so you can see here with just two sets of water runes and a few sky drops, 11 combos, way overkill. Right, in fact, I don't think you need Aquarius active skill, but since it's ready, why not just use it? Right, so next up we have this extra battle, which is the power release material. So I did make it drop like once, but I failed that the stage, so too bad that material is gone. Right, so anyway, this guy's on 6 HP, so just do whatever you want to do, like stall or what. Whatever, right? Do it within 3 turns. So you notice I do a Aquarius, Pisces convert. That's because I want to store a few water runes at the bottom. Alright, so just dissolve 3, but after that make sure you have at least 5 water runes on the board, right? Must. Okay? Because you get reset, a CD reset here, and Ursula. Is it Ursula? No. That baby water schema there only enables you to do full attack. Alright, so make sure you have at least 5 water runes. Alright, with that, easy peasy, move on to the boss. Alright, so boss. So looking at my setup, you know what I'm gonna do. Basically, we have Doman here. So Doman's leader skill is once your HP reach below 50%, your recovery times 2. Alright, so my team setup in a way, after one Nihok hit, it will be below 50%. Alright, so very easy here, just dissolve one set of hard runes, then you'll be done. Alright, so you can see that was an accidental touch on the weathered rune, so no issue there. So as long as you have 3 hard runes on the board, right, you won't die. So basically, oh, and you have to dissolve the weathered rune, if not, GG. Yeah. So you notice I have a skull there. It's because his his damage will increase based on the number of weather runes remaining after the end of the round. Alright, so you can see here, I do not have hard runes, but still continue to dissolve away the weather runes. Alright, so here what I'm waiting for is actually for Muye and Molly to be up. So these two, once it's up, it's game over for Nihok. Alright, Muye for the hard convert, and then Molly for the three extra rolls. Alright, so you can make do of something with that three extra rolls. Alright, so Muye is up, two more turns before Molly is ready. So notice that both Muye and Molly is at max CD. So if your Molly and Muye is not max skill, I think you can just pull it off the same way as I did, just that your CD storing will be much harder. Alright, of course it takes longer to be ready, means that you are in constant danger. Alright, so you can see Muye is ready, Molly is ready, turn both of them on, and then with Doman's, as I said earlier, Doman's HP at below, the team HP below 50%, your team recovery will be times 2. Alright, so you can see here with one extra set of sky drop there, 526,000 recovery. Alright, his HP is only 200 plus, so I basically killed Nihok twice with this team. Alright, so I can't pass the chance to do this 3-star achievement. Alright, I think it's a very satisfying clear using this team. Alright, so anyway, that will be it for this 3-star video. So back to what I let you guys vote for. Lucy team got the most vote, so we're gonna do Lucy team first. Alright, let's go. Alright, so here we are with Lucy team. So I'm not gonna play like the front part because you know exactly what is it. And it's very straightforward, alright? Just kill and then nothing much gonna stop you anyway. Alright, since it's Lucy team. Alright, so back here with the power release material. Note that you only have 6 HP, so once you attack it, that's it. So here with Lucy team, take note that hard rune is equal to all the attributes, but do not use hard runes to do a full attack. Right, it's not counted. So notice I do a full attack for dark runes and water runes. So you can see Woodbury does 0 damage. Alright, and with this, moving on to the boss. Alright, Nihok. So I would say Lucy team isn't the perfect team to play this ultimate stage. But anyway, it's still quite a fun team to pull off. Alright. So recovery wise is decent, but it's not enough to one hit kill Nihok. So if you do not have like a Diablo team, or you have Saruman but you do not have Diablo, right, it does not work both ways. You must have Diablo as leader in order to do the overheal. Alright, so here just grind all the way. So take note of those weather runes, and then just try to dissolve all them.
Cannot hear la, cannot hear la.
Alright, so notice that at some point you'll be like lacking hard runes. So what you can do is just to form any columns of 4 somewhere, and then with that you can actually generate hard runes. Alright, since you're playing hard Babylon here with Lucy. So I decided to go for the Dragonic Compulsion here, not because I did a lot of overheal there, but I see that okay, I'm actually running very low on hard runes. So let's just do a compulsion. Alright, so compulsion, I actually turn the most abundant runes into hard runes. Alright, and then with this you can see that it's basically the final spin. Yep, and then with just 46k recovery, just take down Nihok. Alright, so Lucy team is basically an offensive offensive playstyle, right? Even though it's elf team. So recovery over heal kind of battle is pretty much not recommended, but you can still pull it off. Right, not sure for Nightmare because Nightmare is a whole lot of different story. Right, so with this, let's move on to the Yang Jian video. Alright, so here we are with this Dipankara and Yang Jian setup. So you can see that here, all you need to do is to turn on Surs if it's ready at the front field battle, but in front, I actually kind of burst down all the stage. So here, Agatha, 90% HP reduction. If you had Surs on right from the before this stage, I'm sure it would be a one hit kill. But anyway, you can see that here with two spin, you should be able to take down this Agatha. Alright, so moving on is the powerless material. So in fact, if you have plenty of sky drop here, you will basically break through the defense and then move on to the next battle. Right, like what I did here. Alright, 20 combos. And then the fire, even the earth damage went past the defense. Alright, so battle 6, same thing as what I mentioned in the Lucy battle. You have to dissolve 5 or basically a full attack. So here only earth have I managed to do a full attack with earth runes, alright, but fire is equal to earth in Dipankara setup. So with this, easily take down this Ursula stage as well. So you can see that your skill is being resetted at the Dipankara, the Ursula stage. So what you need to do here is to basically survive till all your heart converter is ready, right? Which is not a problem because of your bulky HP setup. So 18k, you can see that one attack is 4k, so even if you don't dissolve the weather rune a couple of times, you are still gonna survive. Alright, so unless you're being super unlucky, you're being marked with a weathered light runes, then that's gonna be a problem. Alright, so other than that, with a 2-2 dissolve for water, earth and heart, right, you should be able to dissolve all the weathered runes every turn. Right, so you can see even without the heart converters ready, I'm basically chipping off almost 1/4 HP from this Nidhogg already. Right, so you can see once the 5 CD converters are up, it's game over for Nidhogg. So you can see that just now there's abundant water runes. So I go for the Stolas convert, which is water to enchant heart. Alright, and then you can see the amount of overheal it does is 91k. Alright, so basically here you can just make use of all your converters, see what color is more abundant, and then use the active skill accordingly. Alright, so do not splurge on your enchanted heart converters at the start because you just have to judge, right? What is there to activate? Alright, so you can see here with one Dipankara's earth to heart enchant heart. I think it's the last spin. I got a feeling it's the last spin. Yep. Alright, so once again another 68k recovery. Managed to take down Nidhogg. Alright, so you can see many people are surprised, like, huh? Dipankara team can clear. Yes, it's possible. Alright, so you can see here, basically is to just throw in all the hard converters of the fire cards, earth cards, and then pretty much you can just pull it off. Alright, so with this, that's all for this ultimate stage video. So Q&A or the giveaway will be in the Nightmare stage. So with this, I'm gonna end this video here. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye bye.